wanted to tell you that the doctor said he could adjust one of your implants so that you won't receive any more homing signals.
Thank you. I hope you don't mind that I activated this program.
Not at all.
I've been thinking about what you said. That this was a place to encourage your imagination.
Is that appealing to you?
I'm not certain. I find myself constructing scenarios, considering alternative possibilities. What if my parents and I had not encountered the Borg? What would our lives have been? I would have been raised by them, learned from them. It would have influenced what I became, who and what I am.
And you would have done the same for them. If you'd like to know more about your parents, there's information in the Federation database.
Information?
It seems they were fairly well known for being unconventional and for some rather unique scientific theories. You might like to read what's there. It might encourage your imagination.
Perhaps I will. Someday. Good night, Captain.
Coffee? You look like you could use some.
No.
It's a human vice you might want to try one day. Keeps you sharp.
One day.
I've been fine-tuning our game plan for tomorrow morning, and I've decided to reassign you to the bridge.
Captain,
I'm concerned about Voyager safety. And if the Sphere decides to attack, I'll need your expertise at tactical.
I should be on the away team.
Alana will do just fine in your place.
You may encounter unexpected obstacles, force fields, encryption codes. I'm the only member of this crew who can anticipate them.
You underestimate the rest of us?
And you underestimate the Borg.
This is more than just a question of tactics. I'm concerned about your well-being and your ability to perform on this mission.
Your concern is unwarranted.
Is it? I'm not the only one who's worried about you. Chakotay, Neelix, the doctor. We've all noticed changes in your behavior. You are preoccupied, agitated, and you're making mistakes. Don't get me wrong. I appreciate your efforts, and we couldn't have come this far without your help. But it's obviously taken its toll. If I'd realized how those journals were going to affect you, I never would have pushed you to read them. And I'm not about to ask you to face the collective in your present frame of mind.
The past several days have been difficult. But I must join the away team, and I assure you I will not make another mistake.
I've made my decision, Seven.
If I don't go, this mission will fail.
You sound awfully certain about that.
I know the Borg.
And I know you. There's more to what you're saying. What's wrong?
Over the past 2 years, I have become familiar with the individuals on this vessel. Voyager is my collective now. Your survival is important to me. I am willing to risk my own well-being if it increases our chances of success. Assign me to the away team. Please.
As a member of this crew. For what it's worth, Voyager wouldn't be the same without you.
Curious proposition.
To say the least.
How do you wish to proceed?
I want your opinion.
They're offering us the assistance we require. I am the payment they require. The solution is obvious.
This isn't a puzzle, Seven. There is no solution. What's at issue here is your future.
The issue is Voyager's survival.
Sit. Please. While I still question this think tank's way of doing things, there is a genuine opportunity for exploration. It could be the chance of a lifetime.
You're saying I should go?
I don't want you to go. But it's not my right to tell you what to do. Until now, I've kept a close eye on your progress, helped you with decisions, but I think you've learned enough as an individual to make this decision yourself. Would you like to join them?
I am intrigued. They are an unusual collective with a compelling mission. But I require more data.
That's why I want you to talk to Gross yourself. See if he can answer your questions.
Captain, I appreciate your giving me this choice.
You've earned it. And remember, if you do choose to go, make sure it's what you want, not what you think is best for Voyager. We're getting out of this, with or without the think tank's help. You're right, Seven. There is a conspiracy here. But I believe it's a conspiracy of one. I've got a theory of my own. Your modified alcove threw your synaptic patterns into chaos. And your mind can't make sense of all the information. So you're generating theory after theory in attempt to bring order to that chaos.
Your reasoning is flawed. My alcove is functioning perfectly.
What about you? You're not a drone anymore. You can't always predict how Borg technology will affect you. You should be in sick bay, not behind that force field. Let me help you.
No! I don't believe you!
Of course you don't. Anything I say gets woven into your paranoid conspiracies. But you should believe me, Seven, because I've never lied to you. And I'm not lying to you now. You have to put your doubts aside and trust me. Stardate 51030. 7 of 9 is severed from the hive mind. The captain tells her not to resist, and she'll learn to accept her humanity. Seven complies and slowly begins to embrace her individuality. Does she regret that decision? Stardate 51652. The captain encourages Seven to develop her social skills. Seven insists it's a waste of time, but after further requests, she pursues it and begins to develop her first human friendships. Did Janeway lead her astray? Stardate 52840. The captain orders Seven to study her parents' journals. Seven claims they're irrelevant, but eventually she reads them and rediscovers part of her own past. Stardate 52841. For the first time, Seven tells the captain, thank you.
It was Stardate 52842. Oh, 600 hours in the mess hall. We had just finished breakfast.
My mistake. Stardate today, Janeway beams aboard the Delta Flyer. She reminds Seven of the bond that's grown between them. Seven lowers the force field, and she decides to come home. Is that you trust me again? father used to call it. We hiked the North Rim when I was 9.
It's an impressive geological formation.
Too dusty. I've always preferred farm country myself.
Bloomington, Indiana. Your hometown. You've mentioned it on several occasions.
So what do you think?
It appears to be a pleasant environment.
When we get to Earth, I'll take you there.
It's more likely this crew will reach Earth without me.
You don't know that.
You refuse to acknowledge the severity of my condition. Just as I did at first.
Are you giving up?
I'm merely accepting reality.
If I'd accepted reality 6 years ago, I'd have settled on the first M-class planet we came across. Instead, I'm 30,000 light years closer to Bloomington, Indiana.
Minus several members of your crew. Ensign Marie Kaplan. Ensign Lindsay Ballard. Crewman Timothy Lang.
Is there a point to this?
Every person on this list died under your command. You accepted their deaths. But I don't believe you'll accept mine.
That's presumptuous.
I'm not being egotistical. On the contrary, I'm trying to make a point.
Which is?
All of these crew members came to Voyager with unique personalities. But I have required your constant assistance to develop my individuality.
And you've come a long way.
But not far enough. I've disappointed you. You feel your task is incomplete. That's why my death will be difficult for you to accept.
Is that what you think? That you haven't lived up to my expectations?
Clearly I haven't. But I want you to know that the failure has been mine, not yours.
You haven't failed, son. You've exceeded my expectations. You've become an individual, an extraordinary individual. If I'm having trouble accepting your condition, it's only because I don't want to lose a friend.
Doctor to the captain. I need to see you in 7 right away. My scans indicate the two of you are genetically identical. The Admiral is you, approximately 26 years from now.
Hello, 7.
The technology aboard the Admiral's ship is impressive. Much of it appears to have been designed to defend against the Borg.
Could we install these systems on Voyager?
The stealth technology is incompatible. But I believe we can adapt the armor and weapons.
Well, Captain? Do it. Maybe we should go back to sickbay. Why? So you can have me sedated? So I can have the doctor reconfirm your identity? I refuse to believe I'll ever become as cynical as you. Am I the only one experiencing deja vu here? What are you talking about? 7 years ago, you had the chance to use the caretaker's array to get Voyager home. Instead, you destroyed it. I did what I knew was right. You chose to put the lives of strangers ahead of the lives of your crew. You can't make the same mistake again. You got Voyager home. Which means I will too. If it takes a few more years, then that 7 of 9 is going to die. What? 3 years from now, she'll be injured on an away mission. She'll make it back to Voyager. And die in the arms of her husband. Husband? Chakotay. You'll never be the same after 7's death, and neither will you.